Welcome to InfOT. Today, we will explore the Human Activity Assistive Technology. The Human Activity Assistive Technology was created by Cook and Hassey in 1995, and it describes a person doing something in a certain context using assistive technology. It is worded like this to emphasize the person and the doing rather than the assistive technology. The activity, the person, and the context are the main concerns, and assistive technology is used to enhance those. The model has four main domains. Like most other occupational therapy models, it is about the person, the activity, and the context. In addition, there is the domain of assistive technology. Let's see the human domain. According to the model, the abilities of a person are divided into motor, sensory, cognitive, and emotional abilities. We need to assess these skills in order to be able to propose a proper assistive technology to our client and to develop appropriate educational programs. We also need to take into consideration the daily roles that our clients have, their motivation, their expected life duration, and their experience with technology. Moving on to the activity domain. Activities are usually divided into three categories: self-care, productivity, and entertainment. In the Human Activity Assistive Technology module, activities are also considered by the time they need to be completed, the space they need, and the location they are being carried over. It is also important to remember that multiple activities can take place at the same time. When assessing the activity that the person wants to do with an assistive technology device, we are able to properly research and choose the assistive device, and we can assess if the device works and helps the client achieve their goals. According to the model, activities take place in the following contexts: physical, social, institutional, and cultural. Physical context includes every physical and technical aspect, such as the weather conditions or man-made buildings that can promote or hinder participation. For example, if the road is covered in snow, a wheelchair user might not be able to move outside. Or if there is a ramp in the library, the user will be able to enter it. Social context includes every social interaction our client has, either a face-to-face or distance relationship. Cultural context are our values and beliefs. Last but not least, the institutional context refers to the laws that can either help or block the disabled person from doing something. The fourth domain is assistive technology. According to the model, assistive technology can be divided into multiple categories. Some examples include high and low technology, soft and hard technology, simple and complex technology. When applying the human activity assistive technology, the therapist needs to consider these four parameters: research, usability, device assessment, and outcome assessment. Before suggesting an assistive device, the therapist needs to research the device, the client's disability, and/or their skills, and decide which device is the best fit. The therapist needs to also make sure that the device is easy to learn, to remember, is satisfying to the client, and it aids their goals. After this, the device needs to be constantly assessed by the client and the therapist with standardized or non-standardized tests. The assessment happens right after the acquisition of the device and in a long-term matter. Thank you for watching InfoT. If you liked the video, feel free to like and subscribe. Stay tuned for more.